Microsoft has recently put in another step towards the next generation. Actually, 13 steps in a form of 13 new games from third-party studios that will come to the new Xbox Series X consoles. And today I wanna tell you all known info about Xbox Series X new games. What are next-gen new games about? Part of them will also be available on the current generation of Xbox consoles. We will have horror, action, adventure, RPG, racing and sports games in this video, so stay tuned! Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and ring the bell, so you will get all notifications about new upcoming videos. Let's start games in for party! And we're starting with Bright Memory Infinite. It's a brand new first-person action game. A fast-paced shooter that combines gunplay with melee combat and Titanfall 2-like acrobatics. Before seeing the title screen, one could even confuse it with Cyberpunk 2077 promo, mostly because of the futuristic car design that you will probably get to drive to. But despite everything we saw, the most impressive thing about this game is that it's being developed by a single person who goes by the name of FYQD Studio. Knowing that, the trailer becomes way more impressive. An early version of the game has already been released on Steam back in March, but it seems that the game has moved on quite a bit ever since then. Bright Memory Infinite will be a truly next-gen title with no plans to release it on current consoles. The release date itself remains a mystery for now. Since no Forza game has been officially confirmed just yet, we can calm down the racing fans, because Codemasters have stepped up to ensure that there will be racing to be had on the new consoles. Actually, the Forza mention isn't really an accident, because the trailer does seem to take a bit of inspiration from the latest Forza Horizon titles when talking about the environments and the overall vibe of the title. Dirt 4 has built a solid racing experience during the current generation, and the new entry aims to expand in every area. More cars, including buggies designed to be turned only one way, more control in the career mode where you'll be able to choose from more event types, and more options for multiplayer, including 4-player split screen across both career and arcade modes. The release date is not clear yet, but the game will support Microsoft Smart Delivery, which means if you buy the game on the Xbox One, you will also be able to download it on the Series X later. If life is too pretty, don't worry, developer Ebb is trying to balance that feeling out with a new adventure horror title, Scorn. You are about to dive into a horrifying world made up of interconnected sections that will be free for you to explore in any order you want. Each will offer a self-contained story and theme that will flow into an overall narrative. During your playthrough, you will slowly gain new skills, weapons and items that will allow you to submerge deeper into the game and its eerie stories. Scorn's release date and smart delivery compatibility remains to be announced. Chorus is a story-driven space combat shooter, where you will step into the shoes of an ex-cultist named Nara, who is haunted by this malignant force that seems to be embedded in her own head. Together with her sentient fighter spaceship, Nara embarks on a journey to destroy the dark cult that made her. So far, not much else is known about the game, except that it will feature fast-paced spaceship combat that we will briefly saw in the trailer. Chorus is planned for 2021 release, with smart delivery already confirmed. EA also offered a tiny glimpse into an upcoming Madden NFL 21 release. Last year's cover star Patrick Mahomes sat in front of a camera to tease us that more details about the game will be revealed soon. So for now, the fans of the sport will have to wait. The exact release date will be announced later this year. But we do know that the game will come with a limited time offer on Xbox Smart Delivery. The original Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines first-person action RPG was released back in 2004, so you can see that the fans of the game have been very patient in waiting for an update. Thankfully, the wait seems to be coming to an end. The new trailer for the sequel starts over the macabre scene of a vampire among suspended corpses, showcasing the creepy atmosphere that you can expect throughout the new game. Besides dancing, you'll get to experiment with supernatural vampiric powers and unique ways to navigate the environment. The developers have mentioned a plan to release the game late 2020, but no official statement has been made, except for the compatibility with the smart delivery. I already covered 6 games, more titles coming up, like new Yakuza, Assassin's Creed, Halo games, and more. Let's continue to review new Xbox Series X games. One of the new IPs introduced during the Inside Xbox presentation was Call of the Sea. The gameplay details of this narrative-focused adventure are still scarce. But the trailer gives us a glimpse into the mystery-filled story set in the 1930s. The main protagonist, Nara, embarks on a journey to a remote island in the South Pacific to find her missing husband. The game will allow you to explore mysterious ruins and exotic locations, slowly uncovering what happened to your husband's failed expedition. You will be excused to feel the H.P. Lovecraft's vibe as you delve deeper into the island and your own memories, exploring not only the physical world, but also your mind. Call of the Sea is later to be released later this year and will support smart delivery. The Ascent is a fast-paced top-down action RPG that will give yet another perspective on a cyberpunk fantasy. It will also allow you to play alone or with up to 3 friends in a local or co-op mode. Need the motivation for all the fighting? Well, you will become a corporate fighter who will fight to defend your district from competing corporations and crime syndicates. The release date will become clearer this year and the smart delivery will be supported. Another truly next-generation entry is The Medium, a psychological horror game from the devs at Bloober Team, who made their name with The Observer and The Blair Witch games. This one is set in the late 80s Poland. You will take control of Marianne, who is the medium. Tormented by a vision of child's murder, you will have to go to an abandoned hotel to find the answer to what is actually happening. The truth lies between two worlds, ours and the spirit one. You, being the medium, will have to constantly jump between the two and explore not only the physical duality of it, but also the inner one that lies inside of you. If that's not spooky enough, you will be glad that the soundtrack for this game is being created by Arkadiusz Rejkowski and Silent Hill composer Akira Yamaoka. The release date is yet to come, and since the game is not coming to the current generation consoles, there is no news about the smart delivery. Bandai Namco Studios have revealed their latest project, Scarlet Nexus. In it, you will become a psychokinetic cadet aiming to become an elite warrior capable of solving the mystery of a new Hayamoka city. Futuristic backdrop and a variety of never-seen-before creatures seem to be the staple of this title. Also, if you enjoyed the gameplay of Bayonetta or Devil May Cry, Scarlet Nexus might be right up your alley with fast frenzied action and a lot of things being thrown at you at the same time. The release date is yet unclear, but the game will support smart delivery. Earth has fallen, and this time it's because of the good old dinosaurs. Second Extinction throws you right into this evolutionary battle together with a couple of friends in this three-player co-op shooter. The aim here is to work as a team to take down swarms of mutated dinosaurs out for your blood, but with an arsenal of different weapons, bombs and tactics, you might just have a chance to reclaim Earth. You will have to wait for the second extension a while longer since the release date hasn't been announced, but the smart delivery will be supported. Times when you could play Yakuza games only on PlayStation are long gone, and Yakuza Like a Dragon is another proof of that. And even though it is the 8th Yakuza game, it will be a fresh start for all the players story-wise, because you will start off with a completely new character, Kasuga Ichiban, a former Yakuza member who comes back from the jail to find that his gang abandoned him. This is not the only new twist, however, as the series moves away from the action-packed combat to a turn-based RPG gameplay. Released in Japan back in January, the game is still waiting for the global launch, and the wait will be over at the same day as the Xbox Series X launches. Yakuza will also offer smart delivery. How we can meet the new generation of consoles without a new Assassin's Creed game? Well, we can't. Hence the latest to the entry to the series, Valhalla. Set in the year 873, the game throws you in the alternative history to the Viking invasion of Britain. Once again, you will be able to mold your character to your liking with more customizations and RPG elements, while also building your base, which will be tied into your game progression and story. You will get to explore parts of Norway as well as a big chunk of England. The developers are promising a more compact world this time around, but filled with more details and more meaningful activities. Valhalla launches the same day as the Series X, and it will support smart delivery. Last but not least in the de facto flagship of a new Microsoft gaming console, Halo Infinite. Little is yet known about the game, but from a couple of trailers, we can already tell that the Master Chief is back, and this time around he should be playing a bigger role in the game. While we haven't seen gameplay yet, the in-engine trailer gave us a glimpse of what the new hardware could be capable of, and it looks pretty promising. While we are hoping for Halo to launch alongside the Xbox Series X, we'll still have to wait for an official confirmation from the 343 Industries. And that's some setup for now. Although most of these games might not look like the next generation, they should only be the very beginning of what the new Xbox holds in store for us. We're hoping a bit more from Microsoft in July, when the company plans to showcase its first-party studios lineup. Which game are you waiting most for Xbox Series X? Or you are a PlayStation or PC fan? Let us know it in the comments. Thanks for watching, we're happy to see you on our channel. If you have suggestions for what gaming stories we should cover next, drop a comment also. By the way, your likes really help our channel to grow, so if you feel like we earned it, don't pity that like button and smash it! Watch our latest video about Xbox Game Pass, which you can use for PC also, or video about open world action RPG shark game Maneater. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and ring the bell, so you will get notifications about our new uploads. That's it for now, and see you soon!